Welcome to the greatest, latest,
baddest, maddest
show,
slam to the mat.
Yeah, man.
You're doggone Skippy.
Hey, what's up, everybody? We are back. Hey, sorry we had technical difficulties from the previous video. We are back. Awesome 2.
Yes.
We are awesome in the building.
Baby.
Hey.
Boom.
Boom, baby. Mayhem the Merciless One. I am G Renegade, the Chaotic One.
Yes, sir.
Picking up where we left off, jumping right back into it, getting the intensity once again. What were we talking about? We were talking about Raw, bro. Finished off
Raw.
Drew McIntyre, Cedric Alexander.
Awesome match.
A+. Look, plain and simple, getting right into it. Boom. This is Awesome Chance came out from that match. I'm going to just say it like that, bro. This is Awesome Chance. SmackDown is coming right around the corner.
Yes.
Bro here, he going to host that. I'm right beside you, bro.
All right.
Boom, going right next to it. What happened next? Bobby Roode versus, for some reason, No Way Jose. I don't understand.
Will he ever win a match? No Way Jose.
Nope. Bobby Roode had to win. Stay tuned for that. Next after that, bro, was the Revival versus the Lucha House Party. I got to be honest. I had a question mark because that whole segment.
That was a match from the past that they shouldn't have revisited.
Everybody, let me just go ahead and sum it up to you like this. Yeah, Revival versus Lucha House Party. The match was interrupted by R-Truth, who at the time was the current 24/7 title champion, who he's great for it. Elias comes in and attacks R-Truth at a certain point with his guitar. Elias then becomes the 24/7 champion, and shit just got crazy. Currently, right now, as we're speaking, unless something changes overnight, Elias is still your current 24/7 champion. Hey,
24/7 champ.
He got some kind of championship. Hey, it's Elias. WWE stands
second one at that.
Right. Yep. Walk with Elias, y'all. Walk with Elias.
WWE.
Right after that, yeah, man. After that, next was Natalya. She came out, did her promo, even though she took a loss.
Whoa.
Right. Yeah, man. Came out, did a promo. It was heartfelt, you know, because she was talking about Jenna Anvil, Nightheart, rest in peace, who is her dad, literally part of the Heart Foundation.
Yes.
I can elaborate on that later. Natalya, look Jenna Anvil, Nightheart up. Natalya cut a promo, heartfelt, love her to death, even though she lost. She didn't beat Becky Lynch. Guess what? Surprise! Guess who comes out? Sasha Banks.
The boss?
The boss.
The boss is back.
The boss is back.
What happened, bro? Tell us what happened.
Bro, Sasha Banks comes out. She comes out first. She came out with her old hair color. Remember that nice little
purple.
Yeah, man. So you think they played her theme music and all that?
The boss.
Boss, she came out. Hey, crowd was hype. I was hype because I love her to death. She comes out, gets in the ring. Gives Natalya a heartfelt, great embrace, love and support and all that. She asks for the microphone, gets on the mic, hey, da-da-da-da-da. You think things about to just be smooth, they shake hands or something, and guess what?
Uh-oh.
Ah! Woo! Sasha Banks! Boom!
Oh!
Slaps Natalya, takes her, like, oh my
no!
God, attacks her. Yes,
heel turn!
Heel turn!
Heel turn!
Oh, and don't forget, that wig of hers, she took it off. Now she has blue hair.
Fresh start.
Heel turn. We will take that.
Uh-oh.
So Becky Lynch comes out.
I love it.
Even though they just had a beat, Becky Lynch and Natalya. Becky's still the man, still the champion. Becky Lynch comes out. I guess she's kind of giving Natalya some kind of help and support. And guess what happens? So Sasha Banks attacks her and beats her. Becky Lynch pretty much, gets her ass beat, respectively.
So,
excuse me.
In other words, the boss turned a man into a boy.
The
boss versus the man. Wow.
Yep, and that's going to start a feud that we are looking forward to.
I'm looking forward to that.
So, everybody, thank you for having Sasha Banks come back. You must have did something right. Bro, what do you think on that?
Hey, I'm excited. I love it. I love the heel turn.
Yeah.
I love the heel turn. I like the way that she attacked Becky and Natalya, and that she made a statement. She's been gone. She's back, and something new is about to happen in the women's division. Becky, your belt, your title might be in jeopardy. Look out.
Yeah, look out. So that's that. Hey, everybody, guess what? What? Tag team division. So then you got the Viking Raiders. Once again, they went against some jobbers.
I like those guys.
I like the Viking Raiders too. They got the potential to do something. Now I just want to see how far they're going to get pushed after they get past wrestling a bunch of jobbers. I gave this match a B- because it's pretty much just the same as I seen last 2 weeks ago. They're kicking the shit out of dudes, beating ass. Great athletes in the ring too for big guys.
Now, before you move on, there was a part that made me laugh. The jobber was outside of the ring, and I think it was Eric, not Ivor, but Eric, the other one, the ball headed one, the smaller one.
With the, yeah.
He drop kicks dude into the panel, and dude is upside down with his legs up. I thought that was funny.
Wait, he just had him sticking up.
They showed him his legs were hung up. He was hung up like a Christmas ornament upside down.
Put that on repeat and re-loop it like 90 times.
It was funny.
That's crazy. See, stuff like that. Shows you the impact of what the Viking Raiders can do, even though it's a bunch of busted up jobbers. I do yes. like the fact that they're taking the kind of old school so you can get a sample sizing of what wrestlers are like.
Yeah.
Without like throwing them into like heavy machinery or the Usos.
But I think sooner or later they're gonna do some serious damage to the tag division on Raw. Look out for them.
Yeah.
The champions right now is OC. Y'all better look out for the Viking Raiders, and I think that would be a good match, too.
Yeah, I think that would be a good match, too. Yeah, it's all good, bro. I see that happening, too.
Yeah.
Viking Raiders, I see they have good
and I would go for the Viking Raiders.
I would definitely go for that Viking Raiders, too. Plus, I like what they do, man. They do, yeah. Maybe they can get kids involved or something.
Yeah.
Then there was Alexa Bliss, Nikki Cross, the tag team champions.
I like them as tag champs, women's champs.
They faced the Kabuki Warriors.
Kabuki Warriors.
Good match. Good match. I gave it a B+.
I gave it the same thing. It was a hard hitting match. It was exciting.
Yeah.
And I like the ring smarts of Alexa Bliss. I don't know if you remember, but she had I think it was Asuka. She had Nikki Cross in the corner and Nikki Cross tagged Alexa. Alexa got down off the ring apron and walked around behind Asuka and popped her. And that right there
was
the beginning of the end. Yeah, the beginning of the end of that match. And and Alexa Bliss is very, very, very intelligent.
Yeah, I like Alexa Bliss.
Yeah.
I like where they're going with as far as her and Nikki Cross because they got kind of like the crazy mix.
It's
with
like the odd couple.
Yeah.
Thing.
It works. It's a setup. It's a setup.
Yeah.
Kabuki Warriors, I like them. I like them. I like them.
Yeah.
I like them. They cute.
Yeah.
Not like that. No disrespect. I got my wife.
No.
Bobby, as far as like.
No.
As a tag team.
As a tag team.
I just.
Let's clarify that. Don't want to get you in trouble.
No, yeah. I love you, sweetheart. But I can see as a tag team.
I love you too, sweetheart.
I just want to know what I can. They can wrestle. They can wrestle. I like their in-ring skill. I like that match.
I don't really see them as champions right now. For some reason, I mean, they're talented.
Yeah.
But. I mean, even with Paige wasn't there, but I don't know. I don't see them as champs, but I'm more comfortable right now with Alexa and Nikki because no one expected them to gel together like they did. And
yeah, me neither.
Now they got the belts.
Right, me neither. Did y'all? What do y'all think? But yeah, B+, bro.
B+. Okay.
Hopefully y'all agree.
Yeah.
And then after that, close out Raw was Seth Rollins.
Seth Rollins.
AJ Styles.
Yes.
Two legends in the ring.
Awesome promo.
Two champions.
I'm still rooting for Seth, though. I hope he holds on to the belt.
Yeah.
He deserves it. I think right now, I think the torch is being passed because Cena's not really around, and I know that they were looking at Roman, but I think right now, I think Seth is carrying the banner of the whole WWE as far as the lead guy.
Yeah, so Seth is setting the tone.
Yeah.
He's setting the tone.
Yeah.
And I feel like now it sets a tone for, okay, who else can come up with me?
Yes.
You know what I mean? Who else can be that guy, or plural guys, not just one or two, but others. Yeah. You know what I mean? Can he be Drew McIntyre?
He's been around, and then the fact that he's a fighting champion, I like that.
Yeah.
And he's not afraid to mix it up with anybody. I mean, you saw it with Brock Lesnar, you know.
Yeah.
But
that's how you put yourself in legendary status.
Yeah.
And at this rate, I feel like Seth Rollins has so much more left in the tank.
He's a future Hall of Famer for sure.
Yeah, definitely. I ain't gonna lie, bro. I don't know this off record and for sake of time and all that, but I would definitely love to see if it could possibly happen.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah, most definitely.
A Shield reunion.
Oh yeah.
If I could see him at least one more time, go back to just that blonde streak, Seth Rollins.
Yes.
And the Shield actually strapped up how they were when they first came out.
I wouldn't mind if Dean could come back as Jon Moxley. I think his character is more rah-rah than Dean Ambrose was.
Yeah.
So I mean, imagine if you add that element to the Shield.
Shield's one of my favorite factions of all time, by the way.
Mine too.
Oh man.
Big time Shield fan.
That would roll like them.
Big time
influences. We rumble against them.
The fist bump. Big time Shield fan.
Right.
Yeah.
We'd have some either great battles against them or great battles with them.
That's right.
Awesome too come first though. Don't get it twisted.
Awesome.
I love the Shield, but that would be dope.
Area 51, y'all.
Yep. But what'd you think about that? I'm sorry, bro. That was high. I had to get off the stuff.
I thought it was awesome.
Yeah.
I thought it was awesome.
Yeah.
And the fact that he's champ, it's gonna add intrigue because it's like, man, who's the next challenger?
Yeah.
And like I told you before, I think Braun Strowman will be the next one.
I like to see that.
And I think that'll be That'll be awesome. That'll be awesome.
I'll take that. Braun Strowman.
He recently saved Seth, actually, from the OC and AJ, handed him his belt. Actually, he tapped the belt and handed him the belt. So that was like signifying that I'm next in line.
Yeah, that's dope. See, I missed it, y'all. I missed it. That's awesome.
Yeah.
So I saw the picture following WWE on the gram.
Yeah.
And I saw them standing like face to face.
Yeah.
But it wasn't like a rolling video. So I was like, what happened? I didn't have a chance. It's like, what?
Right.
Braun Strowman.
Right.
And I was like, okay, maybe that'll lead to a good storyline because I feel like Braun Strowman not getting off of Seth Rollins, but he deserves a push too because he has that ability to carry a company. It don't have to always be a nice, chiseled up model looking guy.
He's in line for a push.
Right. Why can't it be something off? Why can't it be Bray Wyatt at some point?
Right.
But yeah. All right. What did you grade that, bro? I didn't give it a grade because I didn't see the whole entire.
I didn't grade it. Yeah. But as far as my overall grade for Raw, I graded it a B. I think Paul Heyman is bringing the product around. He's doing a good job.
Yeah.
And like we said before, the PG era has come to an end. You know, we got a little blood now, you know, as witness from what Brock did to Seth Rollins a couple weeks back.
Right.
But I'm going to give it a B plus. I think Paul Heyman. My name is Paul Heyman. And I'm the advocate for Raw. But anyway, I think that he's doing a good job.
Yeah. So do I agree. I give it a B as well, bro.
Yeah.
I curve a B plus.
Okay.
Because I can see where majority of everything is going.
B plus.
I can see Seth, obviously. He carries a whole weight behind why you give it a B. Even AJ Styles.
He's the flag bearer for the WWE right now.
Andrade, seeing him come up, Samoa Joe. Let's see where Bobby Roode's gonna go. Are they gonna finally try to do something with him?
I think they need to turn him heel, make him heel and make him kind of maybe attack somebody or do something drastic to make some kind of statement as far as him. Before his time runs out. Yeah.
Other than that, I'm glad Sasha Banks is back. Now it gives a little bit more.
Welcome back, boss.
To the women's division.
We're glad to have you back.
Yep.
Get that belt. Beat the man. We want to see a little change, something different.
Yep.
Okay.
That's it. Yeah.
Okay. We're going to go into our SmackDown Live segment. Thank you, bro, for that. Boom! SmackDown Live segment. We had an opening. We had Kevin Owens come out, KO. And he gave a decent promo. And he talked about his career and being in the WWE for 5 years and the impact that he made when he first came on. And then the music hits. And then Shane McMahon comes out. And they get into a little squabble. And Shane McMahon was saying that Kevin Owens attacked Elias at SummerSlam, and he had a referee shirt on, and he shouldn't have did that.
It's pissed me off, by the way.
He fined him $100,000, yo.
Is that not jacked up?
The man got to feed his family, so he's taking money out of his pocket, basically.
He's mad because you lost. Now you want to be petty shamed.
He's mad because he got shamed.
And he's still getting TV time, if you really think about it. Still getting TV time.
So KO was upset, and he stormed out of the ring. Yeah. I gave it a grade. I gave it a B. Because the feud is just about over. Kevin Owens did what he said he was going to do. He's beat him. So I gave it a B.
Yeah.
Did you have any thoughts or?
I like the Kevin Owens promo, Shane O'Mac promo. I actually didn't give it a grade at all, bro. But if I were to give it a grade, I'd give it like a B minus.
Okay.
C plus. Okay. Reason being because it ain't like the feud's a bad feud.
Right.
But it ain't like one of the greatest feuds in history.
Yeah.
Great feuds to me is like, oops, sorry, I'm about to get hyped.
DX.
Right, those feuds. When Cats is coming with tanks and stuff.
Oh, man.
When Hulk Hogan turned to the NWO and now they have a
what you doing, brother?
Right, you know what I mean? When you have hard beefs. This ain't one of those classic beefs.
No.
But I feel like it's entertaining because it gives you. You got Kevin Owens, who's a great wrestler.
Yes.
Whether he's a heel or that he's a face, he can still bring it on the mic.
I just like when he kept giving Shane those stunners. I thought it was funny.
Oh,
the way
man.
He would bounce off the mat and flip back.
Flip it back. Yeah, man. And I'm just getting annoyed with Shane a bit. It's time for him to just go away. Go away, man.
Do office work. Drink lots of coffee and eat donuts, bro.
Right.
Seriously. Stay with the paperwork. Do not come out to the ring because we're tired of seeing you.
Yeah, come on, man.
We respect what you do in the ring, but bruh, you need to be behind the scenes. It's time for other people to shine, you know, because there's a lot of wrestlers we haven't seen in weeks.
I'd rather have a McChicken than another Shane O'Mac this week.
Oh, come on.
A cold McChicken.
Oh, gosh.
Man. But yeah, I'd give it a B. I'd give it a B, C plus, because now I'm just kind of getting tired of the feud. It's kind of running dry. Kevin Owens already proved his point. Right. Now Shane O'Mac is being petty, and now he's abusing his power.
Time for him to move on and do other things.
A wiener head in a good way, yeah. Let's keep it going. Let's now go ahead and have Kevin Owens being pushed, because the crowd's behind him.
Yes.
Shane O'Mac.
Yes.
Let's go.
See ya.
Okay. See ya.
Next, we got Charlotte the Queen against Ember Moon. Very good match. The match, Charlotte has been very dominant. I've been watching her matches lately.
Yeah.
And she's been very dominant.
Yeah.
And she's already tall. She's strong. She's got all these different moves in her repertoire. Ember Moon is just barely getting her feet wet coming from NXT about several months ago.
Yeah.
But she's coming to her own. She just recently challenged Bayley for the belt, but she lost at SummerSlam.
Yeah.
But Charlotte... Ember Moon had her moments in this match where she fought back, but Charlotte was just too dominant. And she applied the figure eight for the win, and Ember tapped out. And this match, I didn't grade it high, but I didn't grade it low. I gave it a B because of Charlotte's star power. Yeah. I could have gave it a B+, but I gave it a B because I kind of knew what the outcome would be. So I don't. What were your thoughts, and would you grade it?
Let's see. Charlotte Flair. Woo!
Woo!
Versus Ember Moon. Women's division. Yay. SmackDown, right?
Yes.
I gave it a C. I gave it a C flat. Right? Charlotte Flair to win. The reason I gave it a C, because I felt there were some parts of the match that did kind of drag a bit.
Yeah.
Because their feud isn't a ongoing feud.
Right.
They didn't have a build up to, you know what I mean?
Right.
Ember Moon just lost, right?
Yes.
And Charlotte Flair's been looking pretty dominant
the last couple weeks.
So I kind of already know where the upper echelon's going between the two.
Yeah.
Ember Moon's just getting back because I think she had an injury or something, right? Or she's coming back from something.
Yeah, she was injured. She was injured, put on the shelf for a few months.
Yeah, so she's just, like you
she's
said.
She's not coming back.
I agree with you. She's just getting her feet wet.
Yeah.
I do think at some point Ember Moon should be a champion.
Yes. Future champ, she will be.
Yeah, and I mean a little bit more sooner than later.
Yeah.
Before she ends up like other wrestlers that kind of get, hey, you're here, there, washed out.
Yeah.
I think they need to push her soon.
Yeah.
And like maybe no more than a month's time.
I think she would operate better as a heel than she would a face. Because as a
I'd
heel,
take her as a heel,
heel because oh, as a heel character, you're more at liberty to do more things than you would as a face.
I almost disagree with you.
Really?
Hey!
Really?
Oh, yeah. You know what? You're right. I actually do agree with you. I was disagreeing because I was thinking she should be good as a face.
Yeah.
But I'm thinking about it.
I think they would make her lose a lot of matches eventually if she became a face.
Yeah. You know what? I agree with you, bro. I agree with you. Hey, what do y'all think? Question to the audience right now. You know what? We need to get the audience. What do you think? Hit that subscribe button, y'all.
You're watching this show for the first time.
Real quick question. I'm sorry to cut you off, bro.
Sorry,
just for the fun, I love this. Got to interact with the people. Yo. Real quick, would you prefer Ember Moon as a heel or would you prefer Ember Moon as a face currently right now? And you made me think about it, so I actually curved that. I was going to take Ember Moon as a face, but I actually stand corrected. I would actually take Ember Moon as a heel
because
I like her gimmick with her with the eyes and being able to change her contacts. I feel like that kind of goes with her character and things, and I can see her being a little bit more.
She has to kind of look like if she were.
And not in a bad way either, by the way.
Yeah, she has to kind of look like if she were to attack. You wouldn't know where it's coming from. So that's what the good part about her being a heel, because you wouldn't know, like, is she cool or is she going to attack me or is she kind of... She doesn't look like the type that would just attack somebody. But then when you look at those eyes, it's like, oh, wait a minute.
You know what?
It's like, wait a minute.
Yeah, bruh. It kind of like Becky Lynch for me. Like, I love Becky Lynch. When Becky Lynch first came out to the WWE roster.
Uh-huh.
And I'm like, all right, she has the ability to be star power, but it's just dependent on how they push her.
Right.
Now look where Becky Lynch is at.
Right.
I can see that with Ember Moon, like that kind of slow star kind of, but we see it in you because of how you move. And then at some point you're going to catapult.
Right.
As long as they push her the right way.
Yeah.
Even on down to marketing and stuff. Hey, look at how they're doing Becky Lynch. So, yeah.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right. Who, my, before we go to the next match, I was just thinking, like, you know how last year Becky Lynch became the man during SummerSlam last year, and her whole persona changed, and she became pretty much like the most popular wrestler of the year. So this year I'm wondering who's it going to be. So far I'm thinking front runner. I'm thinking The Fiend might be, because he he's not the same Bray Wyatt. He's different now.
Yeah.
He adds a element of mystique, and people are like, okay, when's this guy going to show up? Yeah, what's he going to do next? Oh, see, with Bray Wyatt, it got pretty...
I thought you were talking about the women, by the way. I thought you were about to say Charlotte Flair, because I was going to say, I agree with Charlotte Flair. I thought you were going to break it down.
Okay, no, I'm talking about Bray Wyatt.
Okay, okay,
But like, you know, Bray Wyatt's old character, after a while, you kind of knew what he was going to do. Like, he carried a lantern, he come to the ring, you know, but now with the Fiend character, it's like he's just popping up out of nowhere. You just don't know what he's going to do next. And that's what I like. I like that.
It has a mysterious element.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I love it. I feel like it's like a, like the old Bray Wyatt was tier two.
Yeah.
Now we have a chance because we still have to see him in more matches. And see. Yes. All right. Here's a funny thing. At some point, though, he's going to have to take a loss.
Yeah.
How does he lose? Does he wear that mask and get out the ring hurting the pain?
Yeah.
How does he, or right. If he ever loses a match, straight up 1-2-3, so let's say to like Roman Reigns, or Braun Strowman,
right?
Now I need to see how he loses. Are they going to turn the lights out and he disappears? So
that's going to be interesting. If he attacks one of them, that'll could set up a feud or.
So that's one thing I think about. Yeah. But other than that, I'm with you, bro. I support Bray Wyatt all the way.
I think they should keep having him attack different people, and then Paul Heyman can kind of figure out who he wants to pair him with as far as a feud.
Yeah.
I would just have him, like you said, like...
Who do you think he'd feud with? Would it be a good feud? Maybe after Finn Balor.
Ooh, that's a good one. I wouldn't mind seeing him go against AJ Styles.
Ooh, really?
Even with the OC there, because the Fiend is like you said, he's mysterious.
Yeah.
They don't know when he's going to attack, and he might just catch him while he's by himself. And that might just... culminate in a tight feud because I think that would be very intriguing. I think that would be very intriguing.
You know what? I was kind of like, but I could see that because that will work. I would take that. I'll take that.
That would be very intriguing.
I'll take that. I was thinking more lines like Braun Strowman because he's a big dude. So now you could pose a threat like, dang, he took out Braun Strowman that way. Even worse than what Brock Lesnar can do. He's the Fiend, Bray Wyatt.
Yes.
Don't forget who he is.
Yes.
Or like Roman Reigns, because we love him.
Yes.
Like, dang, look what he did to everybody's favorite. Or something sneaky like Seth Rollins. Because he's the top guy right now. Right. Imagine if Bray Wyatt just went straight boom like that.
I wouldn't mind seeing him go against another heel.
Or even another heel.
That would be fascinating.
Samoa Joe.
I was thinking him. I was just thinking him.
Drew McIntyre.
Another good one. Yes. that would be dope. Hey. Or possibly he could challenge the King of the Ring, the upcoming King of the Ring, whoever that might be.
Imagine Bray Wyatt being a King of the Ring. Wait, he's not in the tournament.
But he could challenge the winner. Well, that would be kind of cool.
Yo.
Yeah.
This is awesome, yo. Because that shit could go in every angle.
This is
awesome. This is awesome. Hey.
moving on. We had a match between, and this match surprised me, Buddy Murphy against Roman Reigns. And I thought this match was going to be one-sided. Of course, I thought the big dog was going to just demolish him. But Buddy Murphy put some moves on Roman. He hit him a couple times with double knees. And he did like a flip on Roman. I mean, this dude was fighting Roman straight up tooth for nail. And this match went on for at least 12 to 15 minutes. I was shocked, bro. And I gave that match... I gave it an A. I thought it was power packed.
Yeah.
It was hard hitting. It was exciting.
Yeah.
And Buddy Murphy surprised me. He was the former champ at 205 Live.
Oh, okay, okay.
He was the former cruiserweight champ.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But I didn't even know that.
Yeah.
I was familiar with his name, but I didn't know much of him. And I know of 205 Live, I just don't have a chance to watch enough of it, which I should at some point.
Right.
We'll figure that out. All good.
Right.
I'm sorry, I cut you off, bro.
No, go ahead, bro.
Good. But yeah, I gave it a B+.
Okay.
Even though Roman got the win.
Still a high grade.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because for me, once again, I wasn't familiar who Buddy Murphy was.
Okay.
Because originally, and let me go ahead and drink to this real quick, because Roman's my boy.
Roman is my boy, the big dog.
Hoorah!
Hoorah!
So I thought originally Roman was going to run through this dude. I thought he was going to whip his ass.
I thought Roman, he was too.
And then I'm watching the whole entire match, and I'm like, what the?
It was like you were
Buddy Murphy.
It was like you were dreaming and you were watching a jobber actually dominate the match. But he's not a jobber. Yeah, but if
that,
you didn't,
that threw me off.
But if you didn't know who he was, like, it might have been like to you, like, this jobber's holding his own. Like, yeah. What's up?
Because I can see, like, Buddy Murphy got a good physique and all that. He seemed like he got potential to, you know, be a maybe a mid-card heel or something. Or I got to know more of him. I need to see more of him. But from what I've seen in the match, I'm like, okay.
Yeah.
If he's on a roster and they push him right and promo style or whatnot, he could do some stuff.
Yeah.
Because look what he did to Roman, a former WWE champion.
I think I can actually, he's one of the participants in the King of the Ring is Buddy Murphy.
Is it really?
Yeah. So I think this dude might surprise some
guy
people.
Who's going against?
I'm not sure.
We'll check it out later. We can get back to that. We're gonna check that out.
We'll talk about that in the next segment, y'all. Yeah. We'll have that for you, like who's involved in King of the Ring.
Yeah.
And that's gonna be awesome. Our last match.
Yeah, it surprised me. Yeah.
Last match was a good match. I think you graded high in this one. It was the Viper and Revival against the New Day.
Oh.
And that was a physical match. It was back and forth. Everybody in this match was showcasing their skills because Revival, they're ring technicians. The New Day, they can be grounded or they can high fly on you, even Big E. And the Viper, Randy Orton is the Viper. He's the apex predator. You know, he's the legend
that is
killer.
My other boy, right?
Randy
now.
Orton is Randy Orton.
Yeah.
RKO.
RKO out of nowhere.
I graded it a B+.
Really?
I graded it a B+.
Even Max agrees, right, Max?
I think Max gave his approval. I graded it a B+, but maybe I should have graded it higher. But what did you think about it?
I gave it an A.
Oh, okay.
Oh, yeah, and I'd be hard-pressed giving A's out.
A as an apple.
A as an apple. A as an awesome.
This man, my partner, does it hard.
A as an awesome, too.
A as an awesome, too, baby. Yeah.
Gave it an A. I gave it an A, bro.
All right.
For pretty much everything that you said. Everybody showcased their skills. We know what the New Day can do.
Okay.
Even though Revival in the past had a very slow stump, even as tag team champions, they suck. Even though they're great in the ring, and I actually like the Revival, I just don't like how they were utilized.
They you know who they remind me of? I didn't mean to cut you off, bro.
It's okay.
They remind me of. Do you remember Arn and Ole
Tully
Anderson? Arn and Tully.
Yeah,
they kind of remind me of them, like old school,
like the Brainbusters.
Yes, old school to the mat wrestlers.
Technicians,
and they work on your body parts and they break you down.
Yeah.
They're kind of like that old school, and I like that.
Yeah, I respect that too, because it's just a whole different strategy on how to beat your opponent. I respect that.
And they were two-time champs. They just lost their belts. They lost at SummerSlam. Did they?
Oh, man.
They lost at SummerSlam.
Uh-oh.
And
this is now, here's where I'm, man.
No, they lost to, no, it wasn't at SummerSlam.
Oh,
it was on
man.
It was on a Raw.
Oh.
OC.
Yes.
And the Usos
this
were there.
This is how you know the tag team division is still hurting.
New Day was there. Usos was there.
Because I forgot that the OC are the tag champions.
OC are the tag champions with AJ Styles. They all have heart. They all are wearing the gold and the hardware around
them. We're going to get back on that a little bit later. I just thought about something, too.
Yeah.
They better push them individually, too, as a tag team, by the way. Or else there's going to be some problems. We're going to get all that later. But, yeah, I gave that match an A, bro.
Okay.
I thought it was a great match, even how Randy Orton, my boy, finished it.
Yes.
And I love the New Day. It was my boys, too.
Yes.
How Randy Orton finished all three members of the New Day in the ring. Just to prove a point.
He RKO'd Kofi.
Yep.
RKO'd Xavier.
Yep.
And he RKO'd Big E.
Yep. Yeah, man.
So the Kofi-Randy war is not over by any means.
And I was just about to say that. I just thinking to myself, now this is just going to still escalate a good Randy Orton. Kofi Kingston rivalry feud, which is great because they're both veterans, they're both good in the ring.
Yes.
Even if at some point, from my personal opinion, bro, even if you disagree, I feel like it'll be a good setup for Randy Orton, who I think deserves before he rides off in the sunset at some point, like John Cena, who I love
another championship ring.
At least win a right.
I agree, bro.
Yeah.
I agree. One more time for Randy. He's a 12-time WWE champ.
Because I feel like Kofi Kingston still has a little bit more left in the tank to take a sacrifice and leave before Randy Orton starts.
Yeah.
You know,
I think Randy's closer to the end of his career than Kofi.
Yeah.
Because when Kofi first came in the scene, Randy was kind of already broken in like four or five years already ahead of him.
Yeah.
The last segment on SmackDown, Roman was facing Daniel Bryan and Rowan. We have a nick, the Usos gave him a nickname,
SpongeBob SquarePants.
SpongeBob SquarePants. Hi, it's me, SpongeBob and Patrick. But Roman faced him off, and pretty much Daniel Bryan tried to threaten Roman, which was a mistake.
Yeah.
Saying, if you try to go thinking it's us, you could get hurt.
Yeah.
But we know the person that did it, and we could bring him to you next week on SmackDown.
This is curious to me. I feel
yeah, it's kind of weird because it wasn't Samoa Joe.
Right.
It wasn't Buddy Murphy.
Right.
And now I don't know. I don't know if this is just a setup for an attack, because I'm thinking it's a setup for an attack that Daniel Bryan and Roman are going to put on Roman. So if I was Roman, I'd kind of, you know, be skeptical about it.
I've got the stoner face.
What?
Cause I don't know.
It's crazy.
I don't know. I love Roman.
Yeah.
And I love Daniel Bryan and even Rowan because he's a big dude.
Patrick.
Yes. But I'm interested to see like how this is gonna play out.
How it's gonna play out. Yeah.
But until then, I'm like the Riddler with a bunch of question marks.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
Because in the beginning, I thought it was going to be Samoa Joe.
Uh-huh.
Because of the feud that I thought was going to start between Roman and Samoa, which right. I thought would have been acceptable.
Right.
Right, as long as they push it.
Right.
Okay, so it ain't Samoa.
That might be Samoa Joe's face turn. I see a face turn. I don't know if you picked that up or not, but I see a face turn coming from,
Samoa Joe.
Yeah,
I can see that.
I actually think he could possibly get a push, believe it or not, because...
Oh, yeah.
Because he didn't really get a push as a heel. I mean, yeah, he won the United States Championship.
Yeah.
But
it was solid.
But it wasn't, yeah. Then when he went against AJ, when AJ held the WWE Championship, he came up short. So maybe this might be a new thing for Samoa Joe.
Yeah.
I didn't grade the last segment on SmackDown, but overall, I gave it a B-.
Hey!
I'm
looking over my, yeah, I'm like.
I gave it a B-. You gave it an A?
I give it a B-.
Overall, same thing.
Yeah, I give it a B-.
I gave it a B-.
I'm giving it a B-, bro.
Eric Bischoff, I'm starting to see his influence now on SmackDown, little by little.
Yeah.
But you made a comment that I agree with you on early in the week when I saw you, and you were saying that Raw right now has the advantage, it's the better show. It's the better show, and that's,
I feel like the storylines are panning out a little bit more, because like right now, for example, just put a fast summary, right?
Yeah.
Kevin Owens promo, right? Boom, Shane McMahon. Now let's see where Kevin Owens is going to go. He's having a feud with Samoa Joe.
Yeah.
Right? So now let's see where that goes. Let's see where Samoa Joe goes. Let's see how that pans out. As opposed to if you go back to Raw, you got a storyline at least with Rey Mysterio and Andrade, and they ain't even on the top tier.
Right.
You know what I mean? You flip it on back to SmackDown, what's next? The match for the night was Charlotte Flair versus Ember Moon.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Which, we see where Charlotte Flair is going. Right. Now let's see where Ember Moon's going.
I'm interested to see, on that note, in the women's division, how are they going to expand it? Because, you know, we hadn't seen Charlotte in a while, and it's good that she's back.
Yeah.
But I'm wondering who else are they going to bring out of the locker room that's been bottled up for a while? Because it seems like
it's more like a Liv Morgan.
Yeah.
Or
she's undergoing a character change right now, so that's going to be kind of intriguing.
Let's see what happens.
Yeah, Lacey Evans, she's been gone on Raw. I know this is SmackDown. We're talking about SmackDown.
Yeah,
but I think the women on Raw right now, the lady wrestlers over there, they're having more exposure. But I'm more interested to see what they're going to do on SmackDown because it's been kind of quiet.
Yeah.
As far as the show, so it'll be kind of interesting to see how that goes forward.
Huh. If I were to shoot from the hip, I would say maybe they just have some on the back burner for a hot second.
Yeah.
Just to maybe try to figure out where they can fit them in to help the storylines. Because remember, y'all, it's bigger than just the wrestlers.
Right.
Everybody wants to be a WWE Universal Champion.
Right.
But your character itself has to help everything pan out. You know what I mean? So maybe they got certain people off the scene just to figure out where they can be implanted.
Yeah. And I think this is where Eric Bischoff comes in. I'm interested to see the kind of creativity he's going to try to build.
Yeah.
So I kind of hope that he like incorporates more, because there's too many people sitting in the locker room right now that haven't had TV time.
God dang. It's bothering me.
It's a lot of. They need more. We're true to the heart fans, man. You guys got to make this happen.
So much talent sitting in the back on both brands.
Too much talent.
You know what I mean?
And Shane,
bothering me.
You need to be off.
Right.
You know,
Randy Orton should have a beef with him. RKO him.
Yeah.
99,000 times.
In all those meaningless segments, they need to take that off.
Seriously. Erase it. Get it out of here.
So that's our thoughts. Hey, we're at the end, y'all. We will be back with an awesome two. Chaos and Mayhem coming at you.
Merciless one.
Chaotic one.
Yes.
Area 51 on you. Boom. You doggone skibby.
Yeah, man.
We going to see y'all on the next segment. We'll be back with Raw for next week. And also we're going to have the King of the Ring. We're going to let you know who's
the King of the Ring. That's right. We cannot forget about that.
Excited about that.
King of the Ring tournament is coming up Monday. Be on the lookout. They're going to have King of the Ring on both brands. That's what even makes it more exciting. So now it's kind of like having a champion versus champion type situation.
Yes.
In the beginning, honest, before we close out, I was thinking with the whole King of the Ring thing, that was just going to be everybody combined. Yes. Until I realized they were going to have both brand splits.
Right.
My prediction. We should close out with a prediction just for intrigue.
Okay.
On Raw, who do you, at least without knowing fully everybody, because I kind of slipped my mind, but just off a whim. Raw and SmackDown.
I can see Drew McIntyre. I think it's his time.
Yeah, I agree. As far as on the Raw side,
yeah.
I say from a shoot from the hill, I agree. Drew McIntyre.
How about on SmackDown?
SmackDown, at least from what I remember, one of the names that stuck out to me, honestly, was either Kevin Owens or either, I think, was Andrade on that side? You know how the whole wildfire thing?
I think Andrade is in it. I think he is in it.
Yeah, so yeah. I'll go with him. But even before that, I would just say Kevin Owens.
I agree with what you said. I think KO. I think it'll be Drew McIntyre. As a matter of fact, before we leave, they're going to have that final match for the King of the Ring, one-on-one SmackDown against Raw. Ooh. It'll be the next pay-per-view, I believe it is. I think it's Clash of Champions, they said.
I think so.
Clash of Champions.
I think so.
And I can see
on the lookout.
KO against Drew McIntyre. And they've already gone head-to-head. They went head-to-head last week. And that was a great match.
I believe that'd be a good match. Yeah, so, man. That would be a good lockup. Yeah. If not, hey, let's see. Let's see if they surprise us with some other stuff.
Yeah. Once again, with an awesome two, y'all.
Awesome two.
We going to see y'all next week.
Boom.
Peace. Boom.